South Australia will pause tomorrow to reflect on the 30th anniversary of the state's most devastating natural disaster. The Ash Wednesday bushfires claimed 28 lives in the Adelaide Hills and southeast. More than 300 homes were lost. Reporter Brett Clappers joins us live from Mount Lofty Summit. And Brett, as well as the lives lost, many were changed forever.
That's right, Rebecca. Now, one of the many that will probably never quite recover from the disastrous events of that day is the man who had the somewhat futile task of trying to coordinate the fire fight. Now, in the aftermath, he was heavily criticised for his performance on that day. Now, three decades later, he's finally decided to go public and answer his critics.
Lloyd Johns was at the helm of the CFS on its darkest day in history. Three men died under his command.
We certainly didn't have control of the fire for quite a few hours, but we had control of the situation, and that's the name of the game.
30 years on, the 71-year-old's steely guard has dropped, showing the trauma remains.
So I don't have any anger about what happened, not at all. I just got on with life, and of course it's there.
The ex-CFS director has decided to break his silence to let South Australians who lost loved ones, livelihoods, homes know one thing.
We did our best, every single man.
If it wasn't for the courage and bravery of the people who were there, I don't know how much more we would have lost.
His recollections of February 16, 1983 are sharp.
As bad as hell on earth.
Mr. Johns says he was commanding a lost battle with antiquated equipment and faced with the same decisions today.
I'll change nothing of what I did, you know, both politically, operationally wise, command wise. I did what I was trained to do with the resources I had.
At the time, he was criticised for leaving his post, the command centre, to attend one of the fire grounds.
When I sat down in that room, I was the only one who knew what was happening out there.
2 years after the ash settled and squabbles over budgets, Mr. Johns says he was publicly humiliated, pushed out of office.
Somebody's got to take the fall, and I was the selected individual.
He sought closure in coming forward, but this fire may never truly be contained.
Only time will tell.
Now, here at the Mount Lofty Summit, which was all but razed back in 1983, there will be a memorial service held tomorrow evening. Now, there will also be one held in the state's southeast, as there will also be one in Victoria. We cannot forget that 47 people lost their lives across the border during the Ash Wednesday bushfires. Now, some of those attending the memorial services shared their harrowing tales of survival, their recollections with us. We'll hear from their stories later in the bulletin, Rebecca.
February 16, 1983, fires raged in searing heat from the mid-north to the southeast.
And the flames got all around the car and it was burning fiercely when I left. It didn't look as though anybody had got out of it.
28 South Australians lost their lives, among them volunteer firefighter Andrew Lemke. His sister-in-law, Mary Lemke, has now moved on, but it took time.
Total grief and depression.
The 23-year-old was putting in a fire break on a grader in Lucendale when he became trapped.
And when you hear stories like that, and that gets back to the family members, that's what really makes it hard, because you know that they probably suffered.
More than 300 homes were lost in the fires. In the Adelaide Hills, blazes were widespread. David McGowan's fire brigade was caught in a valley in Ashton, trapped by fire on both sides.
There is no doubt we could have died right here.
The crew escaped, navigating through thick smoke. One recurring nightmare remains.
You weren't worried about your house burning. You weren't worried about the fact that you had abandoned your family to go firefighting and they were at home defending. What really worried you was that you may not have come back.
In the state's southeast, 2,000 square kilometres of farmland, properties and pine forests were destroyed. 300,000 cattle and sheep were killed.
It was the hell that we will never forget.
Mike Kemp was the youngest CFS leader in the state at the time.
We had people screaming at us over the radio saying people's lives are at risk and there had been people's lives lost. We were trying to help, but we couldn't. We were having enough trouble saving our own lives.
Equally as haunting, the probability of another Ash Wednesday.
This could absolutely happen again. If Mother Nature decided it wants to destroy this area, it could.
Brett Clappers, 10 News.